Hi, Year 10. Today we are talking about the graphs of circles. So, the main equation that you need to be familiar with is the equation of a circle that has a radius that we're going to call r, and its center is at 0, 0. So, all the circles that we're going to be looking at for now will be having a center at 0, 0. You will next year be learning about other circles that are moved off the origin, but not yet. So all equations of circles that have a radius of r center on the origin will be in this form: x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Okay, now r would obviously be a number. So if it was R is equal to 2, we would have x squared plus y squared is equal to 2 squared, which is 4. And if you were to draw that circle, all it is a radius of 2 going the whole way around here. So 2, 2, minus 2, minus 2. And that would be what that circle looks like. It is possible to rearrange that formula though. So if I wanted to get x by itself in this equation here, you would subtract the y squared across to the other side. So let me write that down here for you. You've got x squared equals y squared, oops, sorry, r squared minus the y squared, moving the y squared across to the other side. And then to get rid of the squared on that x, you would have to square root the r squared minus y squared that you see down here. And also, when you square root, you get a plus or a minus sign in front of it. However, when you rearrange a formula like that, that means that you're actually changing it so that you're drawing semicircles. The positive version of that, so the x equals a positive square root of r squared. Actually, I'll put in a radius there so that it makes more sense. Let's do 2 again. So that 2 squared is 4 minus y squared. That is a semicircle on the right-hand side of the y-axis that would look something like that. The negative one, so x equals negative square root of 4 minus y squared, would be a semicircle on the left-hand side with a radius of 2. If I was to rearrange the formula to make y the subject, you would end up with this type of equation here. That is when you are going to get semicircles on the top and the bottom. So the positive version, so the y equals a positive 4 minus x squared is a semicircle sitting up here on the top, radius of 2. The negative one is a semicircle underneath the x-axis. Okay, now the semicircles aren't very common at this stage. You will come across them in question 19 of the exercise. Most of the time, the questions that you are looking at will be using the one highlighted up here in yellow, the x squared plus y squared equals radius squared for the full circle. Okay, just like in the examples here. So in example number one, consider the equation x squared plus y squared is equal to 9. So that 9 on the end, that is where we get our radius from. So you always have to square root that number. So that means that my radius is going to be 3. But I'm getting a bit ahead of myself because that's in the parts down here. So first of all, let's have a look. Part A, state the coordinates of the center of the circle. Well, all the circles that we're looking at for now have the center on the origin at 0, 0. State the radius. The radius is the square root of that 9, which means the radius is equal to 3. Find the value of y when x is equal to 2. So all I want to do is sub x is equal to 2 into that equation. So that would be 2 squared plus y squared equals 9. Now 2 squared is 4, so 4 plus y squared equals 9. Then I would subtract the 4 to the other side. Y squared equals 9, take away 4 is 5. And finally, to get the y by itself, I want to get rid of the squared, which means I need to square root the 5, but don't forget there would be a plus or a minus sign in front of that. Part D says, find the value of x when y is equal to 1 now. So again, we come back to our original equation and we sub in that y is equal to 1. So that is x squared plus 1 squared equals 9. Now 1 squared is just 1, so x squared plus 1 equals 9. Subtract the 1, so x squared equals 9, take away 1 is 8. And finally, we square root to get rid of that squared, which means we'll have a plus or minus square root of 8. Now, because we love surds, we know that we can simplify that square root of 8. 8 is 4 times 2, and the square root of 4 is 2. So it's plus or minus 2 root 2. Please ask me if you need that to be explained further, if you have forgotten some of your surd skills. Part E says to sketch a graph, the graph of that circle showing the intercepts. So draw up a Cartesian plane. Now remember, these are sketches. The most important thing is that you are showing the correct intercepts and have the right shape for the curve. So we have a radius of 3. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So 3, 3, minus 3, and minus 3. They will be the intercepts. And try to draw a circle going through them. In the past, it seems that a lot of the time they tend to look a little bit squarish, but try to make it look circular, like that. Okay, part F. What is the domain, which is the permissible x values? We talked about this in our last lesson, working out domain and range. Now, for a circle, we obviously have values between minus 3 and 3 for the x values. But it's not actually possible to get any graph, any part of the graph at 4 or 5 or 6 or values getting bigger out that way. So my domain is going to be between, now to write this down, you put less than or equal to signs on either side of your x. It's going to be greater than the minus 3 and less than the 3. So often what I do is you cover up this side of the graph. If you just look at the right-hand side, you see x is less than or equal to 3. And then it makes sense that the other one would have to be that x is greater than minus 3, even though that's reversed to how we would normally read it. Okay, that is how you write that. Part G, what is the range, which is the permissible y values? So again, the range is going to be between minus 3 and 3 as well. So this time we put the y in the middle because it's range that we're doing. And it's going to be between minus 3 and 3. Question 2. Find the coordinates of the points where x squared plus y squared equals 25 intersects with y equals 2x. Sketch the graph showing the exact intersection points. Now, to find the exact intersection points, we are going to have to solve those two equations simultaneously. So, because of that, I'm going to call my circle equation 1. And my line is going to be equation 2. Now, y is by itself in equation 2, so that means that I can substitute equation 2 into equation 1. So replacing y with this 2x, I take that 2x, and in the circle equation, it's going to replace that y. So that means I'll get x squared plus, instead of the y, it will be 2x squared is equal to 25. Now I have an equation with just x in it, and I want to solve it to find out what x is. So let's expand those brackets out. I have to square the 2, so 2 squared is 4, and square the x is x squared equals 25. Now they're both x squared, so they're like terms and can be added together. 1x squared plus 4x squared makes 5x squared equals 25. Divide by 5, 25 divided by 5 is 5. And to get rid of the squared, we square root the 5, but it will be plus or minus. So there is the two solutions. It's either x is equal to a positive root 5 or x is equal to a negative root 5. There's two points of intersection. I need to know the y values for each of those as well. So I'm going to sub those values into my second equation because that's the easier one to sub into to find my y values. So for the first one, y is equal to 2x is my equation. So it's 2 times by x, which is root 5. So it's 2 root 5. That can be written as a point. X is root 5 and y is 2 root 5. Now we want to find the y value for the second one. Again, subbing into y equals 2x. So it will be 2 times by minus root 5. So that would be minus 2 root 5. Again, write that as a coordinate. Minus root 5 and minus 2 root 5. Okay, so we've found the points of intersection. We just need to show all of this on a graph. So draw up a Cartesian plane. Looking at the equation of the circle, it's x squared plus y squared equals 25. That means the square root of 25 is 5. The radius of the circle is 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so again, try to make a nice circle going through all those intercepts. Okay, the equation for the other graph that we had was y is equal to 2x, which is a straight line. Y equals 2x means that the 2 is the gradient, and the y-intercept would be 0 because there's no number added on the end. So to sketch that, I draw the y-intercept first. My y-intercept was 0. And a gradient of 2 means I rise 2, 1, 2, and run 1 to the positive side. Now you only need to do it once, but you can do it twice if you want to. 1, 2, and across 1. All right, but as I said, you only need to do it. You only need 2 points to draw a straight line. So then you draw your line going through those crosses. Like that. Now what we were after were these points of intersection. This one here and this one here. So we know the coordinates of those points. Root 5 comma 2 root 5, because that root 5 would be about 2.4, somewhere in there, okay? So then you know that's going to be the positive one over here. So this is root 5 comma 2 root 5. Okay, then for the negative root 5, that's going to be this other one down here, negative root 5 minus 2 root 5. If you're ever in doubt, just type those surds into your calculator so that you can know where to put them. Okay, so that's it. We've drawn the graph and labeled the points of intersection with the exact values. So that's it on circles. You need to do exercise 9i.